In 2017, McKinsey, a very big consulting company, launched a very important report saying that AI, artificial intelligence plus advanced analytics together will add to the economy, the global economy, $13 trillion from 2017 until 2030. Its new addition to the economy is very big. In the next year, 2018, they launched another report explaining a little more in details where this value would come from. What kind of function, what kind of industry, what kind of function. Here are an example of the function that they predicted at that time with more relevance to get value from AI. They had predicted that marketing sales are two functions that will really get a lot of value coming from AI. Customer service management, next product to buy, price and promotion, customer acquisition, churn reduction, channel management. Those are just a kind of examples where the value is inside this kind of this function. Another function are supply chain and manufacturing. Two additional functions with lots of value with AI. Predictive maintenance, yield optimization, procurement spend analytics, inventory parts optimization. Areas that in 2017, McKinsey predicted that would bring high value during almost 15 years. Yes, from other areas inside companies, yes, workforce productivity and efficiency, predictive service intervention, tax automation, fraud and debt analytics, risk, analytics-driven accounting and IT, and some other areas also. McKinsey predicted that there were value in the years that would come ahead. In the second semester of 2019, a new global survey from McKinsey surveying companies that were using AI at that moment shows some interesting information where the value was coming at that time, or almost present, yes, where the value was coming. And this survey confirms some times of prediction, yes, and you can see in your right here the value is coming from revenue increase and or the value is coming from cost decrease. Marketing sales function, which was predicted in 2016 to be the largest contributor to the value, in fact is the largest here in this new survey in the second semester of 2019. And you can see that companies are applying AI in the marketing sales functions, yes. And the focus here is more in the revenue increase. They are applying AI for customer service analytics, customer segmentation, prediction of likelihood to buy, price and promotion, churn reduction, and next product to buy. And they are gaining much more value in the side of revenue increase than in the side of cost reduction. In terms of product and service development, is this almost the same situation, yes? Companies are using AI to product development cycle optimization, creation of new AI-based enhancement, as I said, innovation, yes? Creation of new AI-based products, yes, innovation. Again, the focus in these functions are much more in revenue increase than in cost reduction. When we look to supply chain management and opportunities in logistic network optimization, sales and parts forecasting, warehouse optimization, inventory and parts optimization, spend analytics, sales and demand forecasting, you can see that there are a balance between opportunities from revenue increase and opportunities from cost decrease. Yes, in both sides. The same in manufacturing, the same in services operation. But you can see that in both sides, it doesn't matter. If you are looking from value coming from revenue, or you are looking from revenue coming from decrease your costs and expenses, you have opportunity to use AI in both sides. Where this value is coming from? What kind of AI capability those companies are using to get that value? For example, here you can see that high-tech, well, they are using a lot of AI. And we can realize that. They are using machine learning, they are using virtual agents, they are using robotic process automation, RPA, they are using natural language text understanding, all kinds of AI capabilities they are using to get that value. Automotive companies, for example, are using lots of physical robots and also robotic process automation and computer vision. Telecom companies, telecommunication companies are using almost every kind of AI capabilities to get the value. Machine learning, virtual agents, or conversation interfaces, computer vision, and even natural language generation. Yes, financial and services companies are using a lot in the customer service side with virtual agent and conversation interfaces, but also using machine learning to risk, to detect fraud, and even robotic process automation to task automation and gain some cost reductions. Yes, consumer product goods are using a lot of physical robotics in their warehouses. Retail companies are using all the kind of AI capabilities. Yes, they are using machine learning, computer vision, natural language text understanding, virtual agents. Well, and you can see that most of the companies in this survey respond that they are using AI and they are using all the different kinds of AI capabilities to get value. But let's move on and see another perspective from the near future.